Rosemary Perrette, CFTO News.
The RCMP and Metro Police are releasing little information about the search for Charles Ng. However, they have said police are looking for the wanted man in Toronto's Chinatown, a logical place for Ng to hide out.
Manning says Morgan Tyler plans to appeal this decision to the Supreme Court of Canada.
Although the Liberals are here this weekend to take care of party business, there will also be a great deal of celebration. Every police officer's family lives with the same fear.
I used to actually role play it in my mind that perhaps one night in the middle of the night, some policeman would come to the door to tell me something had happened to my husband. And that particular night, that came true for me. So it was exactly like a living nightmare.
Constable William Grant was killed in the early morning of October 9th when his cruiser was rammed by a car he had been chasing. His 23-year-old wife has learned to face the fact her husband will never return to their small but comfortable Markham bungalow. He will never meet his namesake. 4-week-old William James Grant was born 2 weeks after his father died. Susan says Billy Jr. and 20-month-old Lara will grow up being proud of their dad.
He was a great man. And he died nothing less than a hero.
What's the most important thing that you would like to tell your children about their father?
I want them to realize how much they meant to him. And I'm sure he's looking down on us right now, and he's still with us.
The mistress of a Greek shipping magnate has just been murdered at an old established hotel in downtown Toronto. She will not be the only one to die here this weekend. Any one of the 130 guests now meeting each other at a cocktail party could be killed as well. If not, they will act as sleuths and hunt for clues that will lead them to the murder or murderers. Any one or more of the people in this room could be murdered this weekend. It's up to the rest of them to try and figure out who done it. If they fail, Detective Haynes will reveal the answer on Sunday morning. Rosemary Perrette, CFTO News.
Good evening and welcome to On the Line. I'm Rosemary Perrette. Because big things really do come in small packages. Robert Browning didn't know how prophetic he was when he wrote that simple line in 1855, less is more. This has been a Metro Recycles editorial. I'm Rosemary Perrette. These tragedies have actually forced me to confront my independence and become stronger and more secure with greater confidence, not only as a mother and as a business person, but particularly as a female in a rather challenging world.
What's it all about? Well, this story is about someone who was born and bred in Lower Manhattan. She lives and works within blocks of the Empire State Building. But other than that, the Big Apple needs no introduction.
You don't just live in New York City. It flows around, over, and eventually through you until you become a part of it. A city that lives by its own rules. Brutal, yet vibrant. Always uncompromising. The city that never sleeps and stays awake at a remarkable pace.
Thank you. By exploring issues both singular and complex, stories that touch our lives daily, stories that could change our lives. News you can use. The Environmental News Desk, only on the Green Channel.
And the idea is to get them interested in the technology of making film and video.
And exactly what do you do? What's the program? I heard you lining up the order of the day. What is it?
Well, this morning we started just with general how the camera works and where the buttons are. And from that we have gone to doing our storyboard, which is putting our stories together. And our theme is the environment. So we're going to be going out and shooting, interviewing, and editing, dumping it back onto a VHS, and screening it tomorrow evening.
Visit us at thegreenchannel.ca.
Rosemary Keevil.
Fur is coming back into fashion, and I'm all for that.
Fascinating.
Doctor Strike? What Doctor Strike?
Hilarious. Provocative.
I'm glad you know your place. Good morning, Michael. How are you this morning?
I want to know why you let the theme run out before you come on. That's what I want. Why do you make the orchestra play to the last note?
I want to know why you're yelling.
Am I yelling? Oh, I'm sorry. What a great day for stories.
It is. It's a lot going on.
Absolute tonnage. I couldn't be happier.
And we're going to talk about a few later. We will talk about Greenpeace, the fact that they're launching another campaign.
Despicable.
Along that same note, we will also talk about the fact that fur is coming back into fashion. And I'm all for that.
Are you really?
Yes. And we'll also talk about the doctor strike.
You know, we may wind up disagreeing on virtually everything this morning. It'll be great.
Well, let's start out by disagreeing on when we should actually start talking with the theme music.
Welcome to the 1999 Leo Awards for Excellence in British Columbia Film and Television. I'm Rosemary Keevil. Putting a motion picture together requires skill, talent, dedication, and long, hard working days. To be acknowledged by your peers at the 1999 Leo Awards is truly an honor. Congratulations to our nominees, winners, and to BC for Excellence in Motion Picture Production. I'm Rosemary Keevil, and on behalf of Ken Hegan and myself, thank you for watching. Now it's time to fade to black.